In this screencast, we will explore the nature of electron energy bands in metals, insulators, and semiconductors. Energy bands are the combination of energy states that electrons can occupy in a bulk material. They are determined by the electron orbitals of the atoms and the interatomic spacing of the atoms in the solid. The first band structure I will discuss is that found in metals such as copper. At 0 Kelvin, the energy occupied by the electrons is shown here in purple. These are known as filled states. There are states that the electrons can occupy directly adjacent in terms of energy, shown here in green. Electrons can easily move into these states and are thus available for electrical conduction in the material. There is also an energy band at higher energy in these materials, but that band is unused since there are empty states directly adjacent to the filled states. That empty band is shown here in black. The next type of material I will discuss is a different type of metals. Unlike copper, which has only one electron in its 4s orbital and is capable of accommodating two electrons in that orbital, thus the empty states in that electron band, metals such as magnesium have a filled 3s orbital. However, there is an adjacent orbital, the 3p orbital, that can accommodate electrons. Though this orbital overlaps, it does take a little bit of energy to get electrons into it, and thus magnesium is a slightly less good conductor of electricity than copper is. Again, just to reiterate, unlike copper, magnesium doesn't have an unfilled state. It has an adjacent empty band, where the band, in terms of energy, is adjacent to the filled states. Thus, it's very easy for electrons to enter that band and be available for conduction. The empty band is shown here in black. The next type of material I'll discuss is electrical insulators, like silicon dioxide. These materials, often ceramics, have filled energy states, just like the other two. However, their empty band is significantly farther away in terms of energy. This energy differential is called the band gap. And for insulators, this band gap has an energy that's usually much greater than 2 electron volts. The final type of material is semiconductors. These materials, such as silicon, have a similar band structure to insulators, where again, they have filled states and an unfilled energy band that is slightly different in energy. However, unlike the insulating materials, the band gap here is very small in terms of energy, where it has about 2 electron volts or less difference between the top of the filled states and the empty band.